Li Feng and Nick Serhey of The Intercept recently published a bombshell story that exposes several Democratic primary opponents to progressive Kaneala Ng, who are all vying to represent Hawaii's 1st congressional district. And how does it expose them specifically? Well, it shows how they were specifically co-opted by the health insurance industry in Hawaii. And it is absolutely nauseating. So getting to the details here, Hawaii's 1st district seat, which was vacated by incumbent Democratic Representative Colleen Hanabusa, who is running for governor, has attracted 6 serious candidates to the Democratic primary in this reliably blue district. According to documents obtained by The Intercept, at least 3 of the candidates took time out from their schedules to talk to a consultant dispatched by the Healthcare Leadership Council, a lobbying group that seeks to advance the goals of the largest players in the private healthcare industry. Now, the 1st district candidates working with the Healthcare Leadership Council, former State Senator Donna Mercado Kim, Hawaii Lieutenant Governor Doug Chin, and Honolulu City Council Member Ernest Martin, are taking heat from their opponents for talking to an industry-friendly group, even as public opinion is increasingly rallying to positions opposed by giant healthcare companies. Democrats running in a primary election will say they support Medicare for All, but what do they say to lobbyists behind the scenes, said Kaneala Ng, a state lawmaker vying for the 1st district seat on a Democratic Socialist platform, warning of Democrats who make progressive promises when campaigning but work hand in hand with industries when in office. We need healthcare champions, not puppets. One of the leading candidates has campaigned on a promise to crack down on overpriced pharmaceuticals and promote single-payer healthcare, but told the consultant dispatched by the Healthcare Leadership Council that he would maintain drug industry-friendly pricing policies and views Medicare for All with skepticism. The council, which spends over $5 million a year on industry advocacy and brings together chief executives of major health corporations, represents an array of health industries including insurers, hospitals, drug makers, medical device manufacturers, pharmacies, health product distributors, and information technology companies. So these are wolves in sheep's clothing. We have one individual saying explicitly that he supports Medicare for All, but behind closed doors, he's telling these healthcare lobbyists, I'm actually skeptical about Medicare for All. And furthermore, I would make sure that we don't do anything about overpriced prescription drugs. What a disgusting, self-serving individual who is literally lying to people to get elected. I mean, if you know that you can't really make it through a Democratic primary without unequivocally endorsing Medicare for All, what are they doing? Instead of actually adopting that position and firmly believing it, they're not really going to fight for it. How despicable, how disgusting is that? This is why I always say you've got to follow the money, right? If somebody says that they support Medicare for All, you can't really believe them if they're taking money from pharmaceutical companies or health industry lobbyists, because at the end of the day, they're always going to fight for the individual who helps get them elected or who they think helps them to get elected. And that's the individuals who are bankrolling their campaigns. So this is nothing more than co-optation. It's nothing more than corruption. And I'm really glad that there's someone in the race like Kaneala Ng who has the guts to call them out, because this is despicable. He called them puppets, and he's absolutely right. They are nothing more than puppets, and this is something that we're going to have to become increasingly aware of, because when you look at DNC Chairman Tom Perez, he's clearly co-opted the language that progressives use when talking about issues like Medicare for All. When he talks about healthcare, he says, we believe as Democrats that healthcare is a right and not a privilege. But if you ask him, do you believe that healthcare should be free at the point of delivery? He dodges the question. So they're saying that they think healthcare is a right. Other Democrats who are corporate Democrats who are currently running for Congress are saying this as well. But in actuality, they just believe access to healthcare is a right. So since they believe in access to healthcare, which I don't even know what that means, since they say that, I think that semantically they have enough wiggle room to where they can kind of say, well, look, since I think access to healthcare is a right, it's a right. Healthcare is a right. You know, they make that logical jump when they don't have the credibility needed to make that logical jump. So when I saw this, I was honestly disturbed, because individuals in this country currently who don't have health insurance, if they have a medical emergency, we all know what happens to them. They die or they go bankrupt. And these people who are running for Congress to represent their constituents are perfectly fine with people dying or going bankrupt or not being able to afford their prescription drugs, all because they want to appease these rich health industry lobbyists and pharmaceutical companies who profit off of fucking us over, who profit off of ripping off Americans. I mean, it really doesn't get any more despicable than that. It doesn't. I would actually take this a step further and say that what they're doing here in lying to constituents, it's actually more disgusting than Republicans. They're worse than Republicans, right? Because at least Republicans tell us, I don't believe in expanding healthcare. In fact, we want to repeal Obamacare, so they want to fuck you over more, right? But they'll tell you that. These Democrats are saying, vote for me, I support Medicare for all, but behind closed doors, they're promising health industry lobbyists, this particular lobbying firm who spends $5 million a year, that they're not with us, they're with them. It's absolutely despicable. Now, I do want to state that I actually interviewed Kalyana Ng last week, and he spoke out against this, and he explained how the Healthcare Leadership Council actually tried to reach out to him as well, but he was the only candidate principled enough to reject what they were trying to offer him. Because it's, you know, it's really easy to become corrupted if winning requires you to take a large amount of money from sometimes despicable characters, but he stayed principled and he rejected their money because he actually truly believes in Medicare for all. He believes that healthcare should be free at the point of delivery, and that's really, really important. Now, I wish I could show you the interview that I did with him, but unfortunately, there were some technical difficulties and I was not able to export that file out. So I was so disappointed because it was a fantastic interview. And Kanyala Ng is actually one of the progressives that I'm the most excited for, because when I talked to him, we talked about really progressive issues, canceling student loan debt. We talked about universal basic income, which he supports. So I couldn't wait for you guys to see it. And then, of course, you know, it gets fucked up because when it comes to technical difficulties on the show, I've had every single one of them possible lately. So I was really disappointed, but I still, like, the overall goal in interviewing people like Kanyala Ng is to let you know that these are very progressive candidates who want, need, and deserve your support, quite frankly. So I'm not going to end this without making a pitch for Kanyala Ng. If you can support him, visit his website and do what you can to get the word out, because this is someone who really is the real deal. If you want a true progressive that actually will fight for Medicare for all, you're not going to find a better ally than someone who rejected potentially thousands of dollars in support from health industry lobbyists. You're not going to get a better ally than that. He is truly principled. So I still do want to get the word out, and I will leave you with this video, which is an ad produced by the people who made the great ad from Ocasio-Cortez. And this really shows what Kanyala Ng is all about. And I'm a true believer. So if you can, support him and enjoy.
Every month, I pay 60% of my income just for rent and student loans. If you're making under $93,000 a year in Hawaii, then you're considered low income. When I was 11, my father passed away. I worked in the pineapple fields to help my mom pay the bills, and later at Walmart and hotels to pay my own. Most of my classmates, my best friends, moved to the mainland, unable to afford life here in Hawaii. We're surrounded by military bases spending trillions of dollars waging for-profit wars, but we have an affordable housing crisis. Our children are moving away, and healthcare is somehow a luxury. It's time for a new era of democratic leadership. My name is Kanyala Ng, and that's why I am running for Congress. It's easy to blame Republicans, to blame Trump for our problems, but we have to look in the mirror. Who controls our state? Who's controlling our party? The people of Hawaii demand housing for all, Medicare for all, a Green New Deal, free college, and student debt cancellation now. The majority of people in Hawaii and across the nation support these ideas, but big donors don't. I'm the only candidate in this race who isn't taking corporate money. As a kid, I remember my grandma telling me stories of my ancestors, how they preserved our environment and took care of each other. She She told me how our people were exploited by colonizers and forced to work on plantations. The people of Hawaii have come together and risen up before, and we can do it again. If my great-grandparents didn't stand up to the corporate establishment of their time, I would still be on the plantation. It's time for us to stand up, not just to leave a better future for our children or our grandchildren, but to live a better life ourselves. A Hawaii for the many is possible, but no one will give it to us. We have to take it together.
Vote Kaniela Saito Ng on August 11th.
Support this podcast by becoming a patron at patreon.com/humanistreport.